All right, it's a, well, not cold, windy and rainy day, but I wanted to do a video on the cooking up some smaller size snappers. So I'm gonna brave it. Lots of rain, a little bit of thunder, lots of wind, but I got my dry gear on, so I'll be all right, and it's just water. So I'm gonna cast net some bait, and then run out, hit the bridge, and see if I can pull some in pretty quick. Where we're at, saddle bunch number 5. Looking a little bit ragged, but it stopped raining for the moment. The tide is going in the wrong direction, but it's not ripping. We're still at the tail end of the king tides, which are these funky off full moon. They come a couple times a year. We get these super high tides, and then we get these extended single tide swings for the day. But I think we can still make it work. I just need some medium-sized snappers, so we'll see what we can do. I should just use cut bait, but I'm just gonna start off with some live baits first, because usually your shot at a big one is right in the beginning. Even though I don't really want a big one right now, it's still fun to catch. Looks like our first victim. That gets all the other stripers, or sorry, snappers. Ah, oh, this is a mutton. Wrong species. Nice fish, wrong species. To cut bait so I can get this over with quicker. And I think we got our first victim. So he's 11 inches. So that'll be our first guy. I'm trying to get between 11 and 12 inches. But I'm dry, and it's not cold. Fish are kind of biting. Looks like our second one here. Ah, fuck. pulled it out of his mouth.
Damn it.
That's the ones we're looking for. Anyways, NorCal Kayak Anglers, NCKA.org. That was my old crew from back in California. I was known as Steve is Lost on that one. Touching 12 on this one, so that's perfect. All right, one more to go. I think we got our last boy, our last victim. See what he measures up to, makes the grade or not. Easy. Ouch. Ten and a half. I think we'll let him go. Just a little hair too small. This might be our guy. Measure him out. Not quite 11. 10 3/4. So he'll swim another day. So we'll let this guy go. Okay, I'm gonna scale this one up. I'm using a little serving fork. Works out really good for scaling. Biggest thing I like it is I could stay away from the fins and then it'll scale right up to them. So this makes quick work of it. Definitely want to be doing scaling outside. I actually did the other ones on the bridge, but my battery died, so I kind of want to just do one to so people can see it. But it rips those scales off really quickly, easy. You want to do a kind of good job. Some people eat the skin, but you can see by having these forks, I don't have to get close to the fins and those points. Hate stabbing myself, especially when I'm just cleaning, but these things will get you really bad. That just work off all those scales, does quick work of it. Do a good job there, the belly, by the gills, and then it'll do by the spines as well. Those are the finger getters and the head. Okay, and we are scaled.
get to the next step, which is gutting them. Alright, let's clean this dude up. I'm just gonna basically cut up the anal fin, lop off the cartilage that holds the gills, and then just rip out the guts at once, cut off these collars there, and then we'll just have the whole fish ready to go. So I'm just gonna go from the anal port and just kind of cut up. You have to break this little spine thing right here, but cut up and away from yourself. This part is a little hard. You want to be careful cutting through. Okay. There it goes. You can see this part where they got the gills. I'm just gonna cut through this part. This is actually kind of tough there. You can use pliers or something to cut that off. And then once you've got that, a lot of times you can do to make it easier is cut there. And they call these the collars. For bigger fish, you can barbecue those. Those are really good. And then just grab hold and pull all at once. And then that takes out everything. It's got the gills, the collars, and then this guy didn't have much to eat. The other one was a piggy, but that all comes out at once. And then we could take our little fork, and then we're just gonna bust up this little skin there and clean out the little spine veins. Just get those all scratched up so they'll come out. And then hose it out. We go all ready and oops, get some of this out of there, some little skin there, but otherwise nice and ready to go. Just noticed something cool. This dude was hungry. A pinfish. Looks like it's still full of some, I don't know what that, shrimp? Yeah, it looks like shrimp. Plus he had this one, which is what I caught him with. This one that he had existing. And he had that shrimp in there. Man, little piggy there. Okay, I think I've got a plan with these four. This one I'm just gonna do plain basic, a little bit of olive oil, salt and pepper, just bare basics. This one I think I'm gonna just do, just add some lemon and onions and on top of it. These two I'm gonna foil pack, and with lemons, onions, some spices, oil, a little water to kind of steam them. And then this one, I've got a little additive I'm going to throw on there. So that's the plan. Okay, let's start with the smaller one first. Good tip is, because of the thicknesses vary from the center chest back to the tail, do some cuts in the sides. And what that'll do is allow it to cook in a little bit more evenly versus the thinner in the back here. So you're just basically scoring them, and it'll also be good to hold your spices. Don't need a lot, especially towards the back. So we've got those there. Oops. A bit of skin there. Okay. So on this one, we're just going to do a real basic as you can be. Just going to drizzle a little bit of olive oil. It's a bit much, but get it inside there. And then I'm just going to do some cracked pepper. Some salt. My hands are oiled up. Alright. And we've just got basically salt and pepper and oil. And that one's ready. Okay, for this second one, pretty much the same thing. We're just going to spice this one up a bit. There we go. Okay. We'll just do some salt and pepper again. A little bit of Cajun, give a little bit of oomph. And we'll do a little bit of garlic. Work that into the cuts there a bit. Here, work it in, and then we're just going to stuff this a little bit. Not so big, so not going to hold too much. We'll probably just lie those on top of it then. But that's the second one. Hurts. And for these last two, I'm going to do a foil wrap. Alright, this guy here. We'll just score these. Ooh, a little bit much on that. I'll go with that one. I always like a little bit of a Cajun. And I'm not too concerned on getting both sides since I'm going to flip it and all that oil's going to drain into each other. Like that. And then we can fold this over.
snapper.
And we're just gonna make a little pocket out of it. This is super cheap foil, so just being a little careful with it. And add a little bit of water. And that's just gonna help steam it up. Okay, that pack's ready. And then we'll do one more. Okay. That one's definitely got the garlic on it. Seal this baby up. You could use a wine or something to add for the steaming part of it, but I'm not too real picky. We're ready. All right, let's get these guys on the grill here. I'm just gonna put that on there for the non-foil packs. And then this side has the foil packs. Alright, everything's cooking nicely. I just want to watch this side because of that flame. Oops, lost his tail. Alright. Just gonna do a 180 on these guys. I'm gonna flip these over. This is cheap foil, so rough business. These guys are looking perfect. Everything's flipped and flopped. All right, let's plate these guys up. That head is gonna come right off. No, ooh. Can have the skin, don't take the meat. There it goes. That one came out nice. This dude. This one's gonna lose the skin, but that's okay. It lost its tail as well, so. Ouch. That's that one. Got the foil ones. Ooh. Cheap foil, but kept it clean. We're good there.
All right. So, we have our completed meals here. So we got just plain olive oil, salt, pepper. You could probably use butter, margarine, whatever, just to coat the meat a little bit. But got plain. Then got this one where we did a little bit of onions, lemons, and the spices. Then for the mystery ones, I could tell this one. Had the works. So this one's all juiced up with the onions and lemon and then olive oil and then basically steamed. So these always come out nice and juicy and flaky. Look at that. Always moist. Can't make a mistake on there. Leave it on for half an hour or an hour and it'll come back and it'll still be moist. So those are really good that way. Then, although this was the works, this one is going to be the one if you want to be a little bit, want to get your Asian on. Oops. So I'm going to prep this one here. So just basically just spice a little bit of olive oil, but to make it that super special meal there, and you would want to take these out of the foil, but tastes good. All right, I'll be right back for the pièce de résistance. All right, to make it like over the hill type excellent, okay, get your Asian on. What we've got here, you're just gonna get a frying pan, just a small one because you're not going to use a lot. Just a touch of all vegetable oil. This is canola oil. You'll probably go, and then sesame oil. You'll probably go like one part sesame oil to two parts of vegetable oil. And you're not needing a lot, maybe one tablespoon, two tablespoons. Okay. And then for a little bit of a spice in there, we've got a little bit of jalapeno, a little bit of ginger, some diced scallions or green onions, a little bit of regular yellow onions, and then a little bit of garlic. Oops. So what we're gonna do, I'm just gonna put a little splash, about 2 tablespoons of that. Got the olive oil, then you're just gonna do about a tablespoon of sesame oil. Mix that up a bit. This is probably enough for a couple of them. Then I'm gonna do it on this one here, but you could just put a few of the raw ones on here. So you have a little bit of a crunch. Then I'm gonna go hit the stove with this and I'll be right back. All right, we're ready. That baby is hot oil. Ooh, didn't think this out. All right, that's gonna be funky there. All right. You just want to get this stuff in that hot oil just for a minute or two to release its flavors. But you don't want like crispy vegetables. Then, once you just gave it a few seconds to kind of release its juices, get it flavored up, and then drop that baby on your fish. Some on this one here too. Bam. And there you go. So we've got plain as you can be, spicing it up a little bit of lemons and onions, right on the grill. Then we've got the steamed with the onions and lemon. And then you've got the steamed and then put an Asian hot oil mix on it. So there we go. And that's how you do it. So we got like 10 to 11 and a half inch snappers. Plenty of food for 3-4 people. I got my neighbors gonna be coming, so this is more than enough for three of us. But anyways, hope you enjoyed that. Weather sucks, wind sucks. It's Fantasy Fest weekend. Might go out fishing with Joe, I'm not sure. It's 25, 30 knots, rain. I'm supposed to have 2 inches of rain this weekend. And then all the knuckleheads for Fantasy Fest, so I'd be good to get off the island here. But anyways, hope that helped. Feel free to give it a shot and let me know how it went. Thanks for watching.